Okay, in this video, I am going to show you the magic that is Marvelous Designer plus 3DS Max for creating soft, organic couch cushions or other furniture or anything that you need to look soft and have wrinkles in it and all that kind of stuff. It's a great workflow. And one of the focuses of what I'm going to do here, this method, is keeping really nice quads and really nice modeling, clean modeling, efficient modeling, and maintaining good edge loops and UVW unwrapping. Okay, so what I'm doing here is starting with a basic shape of a cushion, like really basic. And then I have a UVW unwrap on it. I have other videos showing how to do that if you don't know how. It's actually a lot easier than it seems, especially something simple like this. But if I open the UV editor inside of the unwrap UVW modifier, you can see that I have everything laid out as separate pieces of fabric. And these will actually translate into Marvelous Designer, at least with Marvelous Designer 8, they will. Okay, so these exact panels will come in to Marvelous Designer if we export this properly. So first step is to get everything unwrapped like this, and you'll see why in just a second. So we can take this basic shape, which is super easy to unwrap because it's so basic, and then we'll just export it, and we're going to export it as an OBJ and save it. I'm replacing an old one. Default settings is fine. Export, done. Okay, that's all we have to do here. In Marvelous Designer, let's open that up, and we can import our OBJ here. And what we want to do is load it as an avatar first. We can turn off automatically add arrangement points because that's for if we're importing it onto a person. We don't need that, so turn it off, hit OK. And there is our avatar. You can see it in gray over here. Now, what we're going to do is just import again. And this time we're going to load it as a garment and trace 2D patterns from UVW map. So this is where our unwrap comes into play. Hit OK. And you'll see it appear over here. Okay, so there's our exact unwrap right there. And everything, all those panels are placed perfectly right here on our object. That's the avatar. If I select these objects, you can see that I can move them away from the avatar. And all my panels are sitting right there. Okay, so I'm actually going to do that with all of them. Move them away a little bit from the avatar. Now, the only thing I don't like about this, I mean, this feature is awesome that it brings in panels. I've looked for a way to turn off the sewing because the sewing rarely works exactly how I want it to. So I usually go back and do it manually. So I wish I could just turn off all the sewing when it comes in. I haven't found a way to do that yet. So let me know if you do. The other thing is this panel comes in kind of reversed. You can see it's a little darker than the others. I actually want to flip it and put it back into place so that it's facing the same direction. Well, so that the normal is facing out like the other pillows. That way, if we put pressure on these panels to push in or out, everything will be pointing in the same direction. Otherwise, this one would suck in while that one's pushing out, which we don't want. Okay, so like I mentioned, the sewing is not quite right. You can see that it's not sewing all the way to the corner here. So if we go to our Edit Sewing tool, what I'm going to do is just delete this and show you a cool new trick that is available with Marvelous Designer 8. And again, I think it's new for Marvelous Designer 8. Okay, so all the sewing is deleted. And now we can just go into the sewing tool, and instead of guessing which side lines up with which side over here in 2D, we can now just sew in 3D, which is awesome. Okay, so all we have to do is do it here and make sure those tick marks add up or line up. Tick mark here, tick mark there, boom. This corner needs to be done too, as do the other corners. You can see how fast and easy this is sewing in here. And then the last thing is the bottom. Sew lines galore. Okay, there we go. all the sewing is done. The only other thing I'm going to do here is right-click and go to Simulation Properties over on this left panel over here. And I'm going to turn off the ground collision because I actually have this sitting below zero. And so I don't want it getting interfered with on the ground there. So let's just turn off the ground for now. Ground collision off. That's what I want. Okay. And then let's simulate, see what happens. Okay, so there's our basic shape of a cushion, which is nice. There's a little bit of wrinkling going on. So now all we need to do is get everything right in Marvelous Designer the way we want it. So we can do lots of different things. One thing I think we will want to do is actually not on this one, though. Which one's that? Okay, so I'm going to select all my panels except for the bottom and put a little pressure in them, like two. So they all kind of start blowing out a little bit. You can see if I put it really high, then that cushion starts getting really high. You don't want that. I think two is what I want here. And then if you guys don't know a lot of settings in Marvelous Designer, the way we can make this look more soft and organic is one way to do it is to turn up these shrinkage and weft and shrinkage warp, which is two different directions of how much this thing can basically stretch. So on this top one, if we select it and go to its properties here, if we put this at like 120, see what it does? Now it can stretch like a whole bunch. And if we put this at 120, it'll stretch the other direction a whole bunch. So now it's just, although it's only this big, it's stretching really far and getting really expanding a lot for this cushion. Okay, so that's like a really soft beanbag type thing. These ones we can add a little shrinkage weft and warp into them, like 105, and then they'll expand and get all wrinkly too. Okay, those look good. And then on the top, let's turn down that one because it's exaggerated so much to 105. Okay, so now we have a super wrinkly pillow. That's nice, actually. Okay, I like it. Maybe we could add a little more wrinklage to the top there. Something like that. I like it. Okay, cool. So now you can see we just use that avatar as kind of a base, and we use the UVW unwrap as fabric panels and then sewed them together and made this super cool simulation here. Okay, so all we need to do is now export it back to 3ds Max. Make sure everything's selected and export. OBJ selected. Cushion from Marvelous Designer. We'll go with thin. We will make it single object. This is one thing that we need to look at. Single object unwelded or multiple objects, and it will be unwelded there. We can also do single object welded. Oh yeah, single welded, because we're actually going to use retopo tools in here, and this is going to be our actual model anyway. So a single welded is great. You don't want it unwelded, actually. So if we import now, import our cushion from MD, import. Okay, you can see that the cushion is actually just in here. We didn't worry too much about the modeling or anything, or the subdivisions. And we could have turned up the subdivisions. In Marvelous Designer, you can take all these panels and turn up, well, actually turn down the particle distance. That makes it more tessellated. Okay, you can also go down and turn miscellaneous. And these are this is the properties panel for each of these different panels. I've got them all selected. So I'm changing them all at one time. I can say mesh type quad. Okay, and then I can put the particle distance to like 10, and that makes it way more high resolution, and it puts it all to quads. We actually don't need to worry about that because we're not going to use this actual model. We're using it as kind of a morph target. Oh wow, something got super messed up about my scale. Let me fix that real quick. Okay, make sure that you're exporting with the same units that you were using. Single object, weld, everything good. Okay, now when I import it this time, it should be right on the money. Okay, very good. So my original model, the simplified one, is actually sitting right under here. And I'm going to take it and make it, well, let's convert it to a net poly first. And then let's just make it slightly larger than our cushion here. And let's make it slightly larger this way too. And let's do a reset X form on it since we just scaled it. Convert to edit poly. Okay, now what we're going to do here is take that object we used from Marvelous Designer and go to Freeform. Okay, make sure this import is converted to edit poly. Go to Freeform in your ribbon tools, and we're going to use these tools, these retopo tools here, and use a conform brush to conform this outer simplified mesh to this inner complicated mesh. Okay, so all we have to do is say, instead of painting onto a grid, we're going to paint onto an object, draw on surface, and then we can pick our complicated mesh under here. And it's apparently called default. Great. And then we can select this poly and hit conform, and it will actually start painting right onto that mesh, right? Like that. But it's a little too simplified, obviously. It is working, but it's too simplified. Okay, so now what we want to do is go and kind of add tessellation into this simplified one to match where we want all our nice wrinkles and everything like that. So the way that we can do that is let's do one turbo smooth on it. Okay. One turbo smooth. And now what we can do is start going in and let's convert it to edit poly. And we can go in and start using the cut tool to just start adding in tessellation, okay? And the way to do that for wrinkles would just be to start here and go to here, for example. The only thing you don't want to do is stop. So later, if I want to add some seams into this thing, I want to be able to loop like this around the cushion. If I start cutting it, and I stop my cut right on this nice line here, then when it turbo smooths again, it will break up this line and I'll no longer be able to loop that selection there. Okay, so just keep that in mind. I'll show you what I mean. If I turbo smooth here, okay, now we have a nice tessellation there. These are all quads. If I left it like this, and put it right here on this edge, and then turbo smooth. Now, when I try to select this, let's see. Okay, if I converted this to an edit poly and then tried to select a loop here, it'll end right there. Okay, so if I have a bunch of cuts that are ending right on that edge, that edge loop I want to select later for my seams, it's gonna be distorted and it's not gonna select easily. So anyway, I just avoid stopping my cuts there altogether. And that's kind of handy anyway, because like you don't want a wrinkle just to stop at that line anyway. You want them to kind of nicely go around the corners. So that's fine. Let's go back to our cut tool and just go and cut this thing up and try to match kind of some of the detail that is showing below where there's a lot of wrinkles. We need more cuts. Where there's no wrinkles, we don't need any cuts. And that will keep our model super efficient when we go to finally turbo smooth it. So I will pause the video while I go and do a bunch of cuts in here, and I'll be back in a sec. Okay, I'm just still cutting away here. It's a nice cut there. We'll do a cut this way. So I want lots of cuts along these edges and along these sides of the pillow. Okay, so just like this all the way around. And when it turbo smooths, it's going to look like this. Okay, so it'll add nice detail where all those wrinkles want to be. Perfect. So, okay, this time for real, I'm going to keep it paused and I'm going to go do all these cuts. Okay, I've got a lot of the cuts done. Just kind of freestyling here a little bit, just picking random edges. Okay, another thing you can do that I didn't mention, though, is that you can also select, like, large swaths of your model. Okay, and you can go to tessellate, which is a thing in here, right there. Boom. Okay, so that just adds more geometry to that area, and when you turbo smooth, it's still all quads, okay? So you can add a ton of detail right there. So let's leave this like this for now. Actually take out the tessellation. Okay, and let's just go in and start painting this thing. Just save it as it is. So let's go in and start. We need to convert it to an edit poly. And remember, because it's already unwrapped, we can go in and look. We'll see that we still have a perfect unwrap here, which is awesome. It makes it really easy to apply some sort of fabric to this with a pattern on it. No problemo. Okay, and now we can conform it and make a bunch of cool wrinkles in it too. Make sure you paint pretty perpendicular to the underlying model. And this is just to make really clean geometry for you, while still maintaining the organic shape and maintaining your edges and maintaining your UVW unwraps. Everything is maintained. And you still have the ability to go back and edit this thing because the topology is so clean. Okay, so you can be a lot more careful about all this stuff, where you put your cuts and everything, how closely your simplified model matches the outline of your Marvelous Designer model. All those things come into play here on how this is going to turn out. But let's look at what we've got here. So that's a pretty cool model. Okay, see on the edges, because I didn't line it up too well, it comes out kind of getting some weird creases in here. We can also do something like a relax. Okay, and that causes us to lose some of the details. But we could come back down and conform it again. Get it right on there, conform it again. Okay, so you can see how this can work. Let's do some more conforming after we did a relax. Add some more detail in there. We can even turbo smooth it more or add some more cuts. Whatever we want to do, if we want to add more detail. Okay, but there you go. There's a really nice, efficient quad model that matches this kind of nasty one that came out of Marvelous Designer quite well. Okay, and then so what I would do now is go in here, take this, and we can do our loops. And we ended one right on the edge there, like I said not to do. Dang it. Okay. But in general, selecting our loops is pretty good. Actually, we're on the wrong one, that's why. Maybe loop it up here. Yeah, there we go. Loop. You can see because the fact that we have these nice edge loops maintained here kind of is really helpful when we want to go back in and remodel. So we could do a extrude here. And just kind of give it some width. Give it some of that. It's one way to create a little seam there. And then do one last turbo smooth. Okay, there is a nice clean model with some nice wrinkles. Look at that. That is a soft looking pillow. Okay, so there you have it. That's one technique for making really clean, nice, fully unwrapped, wrinkly cushions. Let's look at it in clay mode. There you go. Okay, hope you liked it.